فيقول نادوا شركائي الذين زعمتم فدعوهم فلم يستجيبوا لهم وجعلنا بينهم موبقا ورأى المجرمون النار فظنوا أنهم مواقعوها ولم يجدوا عنها مصرفا ولم يجدوا عنها مصرفا ولقد صرفنا في هذا القرآن للناس من كل مثل وكان الإنسان أكثر شيء جدلا وما منع الناس أن يؤمنوا إذ جاءهم الهدى ويستغفروا ربهم إلا أن تأتيهم سنة الأولين أو يأتيهم العذاب قبلا وما نرسل المرسلين إلا مبشرين ومنذرين ويجادل الذين كفروا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق واتخذوا آياتي وما أنذروا هزوا ومن أظلم ممن ذكر بآيات ربه فأعرض عنها ونسي ما قدمت يداه إنا جعلنا على قلوبهم أكنة أن يفقهوه وفي آذانهم وقرا وإن تدعوهم إلى الهدى فلن يهتدوا إذا أبدا وربك الغفور ذو الرحمة لو يؤاخذهم بما كسبوا لعجل لهم العذاب بل لهم موعد لن يجدوا من دونه موئلا وتلك القرى أهلكناهم لما ظلموا وجعلنا لمهلكهم موعدا وإذ قال موسى لفتاه لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبا فلما بلغا مجمع بينهما نسيا حوتهما فاتخذ سبيله في البحر سربا فلما جاوزا قال لفتاه آتنا غداءنا لقد لقينا من سفرنا هذا نصبا قال أرأيت إذ أوينا إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت وما أنسانيه إلا الشيطان أن أذكره واتخذ سبيله في البحر عجبا قال ذلك ما كنا نبغي فارتدا على آثارهما قصصا فوجدا عبدا من عبادنا آتيناه رحمة من عندنا وعلمناه من لدنا علما قال له موسى هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا وكيف تصبر على ما لم تحط به خبرا قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أعصي لك أمرا قال فإن اتبعتني فلا تسألني عن شيء حتى أحدث لك منه ذكرا فانطلقا حتى إذا ركبا في السفينة خرقها قال أخرقتها لتغرق أهلها لقد جئت شيئا إمرا قال ألم أقل إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت ولا ترهقني من أمري عسرا فانطلقا حتى إذا لقيا غلاما فقتله قال أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس لقد جئت شيئا نكرا قال ألم أكن لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا قال إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها فلا تصاحبني قد بلغت من لدني عذرا فانطلقا حتى إذا أتيا أهل قرية استطعما أهلها فأبوا أن يضيفوهما فوجدا فيها جدارا يريد أن ينقض فأقامه قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا صدق الله العظيم.
صدق الله مولانا العظيم. Verily Almighty Allah speaks the truth. Jazakallah khair, shukran, and baitrama kasi to our young Hafiz Abdul Qadir Naqidin for that very melodious rendition and tilawa of the glorious Quran. May Almighty Allah accept and may Allah bless us all through the barak of the Quran. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. My dearly beloved Jamaatul Muslimin, respected elders, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, and our beautiful children, as well as our viewers on Facebook and YouTube, on the social media, I greet you all with the wonderful Islamic greetings of peace, love, and mercy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome our honorable Ustad, Al-Sheikh Sayyid Muhammad bin Yahya al-Nanawi to Cape Town and to Masjid al-Quds once again, speaking to us today on the very important and current topic, the importance and lessons from the Isra wal Mi'raj. Sheikh Nanawi, of course, needs no introduction whatsoever. It's our very own Sheikh, and we are extremely honored to have you. Sheikh, indeed, your visit today has blessed Cape Town, and on behalf of the entire Cape Town and our Jamaat, we say Alf Marhaban Ahlan wa Sahlan, Natasharraf bihudurika ya Ustadh al-Kareem, falatafaddal mashkura.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النور المبين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين ورضي الله عن أزواجه وذرياته وأصحابه وأحبابه والتابعين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا من حوله لنريه من آياتنا. The beginning of Surah Al-Isra and the beginning of Surah Al-Isra speaks about the event of Isra and Mi'raj, obviously by notion to Mi'raj. Most of the ulama of the seerah estimate that the Isra and Mi'raj event happened in the month of Rajab, the month that we're in now. Though we don't have any explicit authentic evidence to that, lakin that's an intellectual scholarly guess that seems to be reiterated And it's no coincidence that we should be touching base on some of the many lessons of the Isra and Mi'raj in this beautiful month, or this significant glorified month of Rajab. First of all, Rajab, شهر معظم. Rajab means glorified. And Rajab is among the 4 months that Al-Quran Al-Kareem designate as Ashhur Hurum. Those are haram months, sacred months. And sacred was not just, is not just to Muslims. It was even sacred to the people who used to worship idols before Islam, to the point that they refused to shed blood in the month of Rajab and other months that are sacred. They wanted to give themselves a break from bloodshed and corruption throughout the year, so they've designated months that are glorified, in which no bloodshed, no harm, no evil should be done. Rajab is one of them. I don't want to speak about the usual lessons of Isra and Mi'raj, because most of you already know them, probably better than me. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was subject to harm by talk, by action. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's uncle Abu Talib, who protected him for all these years, passed on. Our mother Khadijatul Kubra also passed on. He sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam goes to At-Ta'if, which is about 60 kilometers or so from Mecca, walking to give them da'wah and to share the love and mercy with them, only to be faced with slander, with throwing stones and throwing filth and saying bad things to him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And At-Tabarani narrates, wal hadith hasanun fi babihi, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam allegedly said this beautiful dua that I personally like, and I know the hadith is not at the highest level of authenticity, but it's at a minimal level of admissibility, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in At-Ta'if, after they treated him, so he was in an embargo with Quraysh for maybe 3 years, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that embargo of Quraysh in Mecca was, I don't know if I should call it inhumane, but no food, no water, no electricity, no, there was no fuel. In the old days, there was no fuel, and electricity was not an issue, because there was no fuel and electricity. But they deprived them and tried to deprive them of everything possible. The Quraysh, the Meccans, wanted to suffocate and slowly kill all the prophetic tribe, even those who did not announce their Islam. After that, obviously, as the end of that, Khadija radiallahu anha, Abu Talib pass away. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes to At-Ta'if. They treat him that way. And then he says that, alayhi wa sallam, he says this beautiful dua, Allahumma ilayka ashku dha'fa quwwati. And I have tried this dua many times, and I think it's one of the beautiful duas, and it works. Try it. Ya Allah, after they treated him this way, the Prophet ﷺ secluded himself in a ta'if, under a tree. And he said, Allahumma ilayka ashku da'fa quwwati. Ya Allah, to you only I complain about my weakness. To no one else, but to you. I don't complain about you or you decree. Be careful. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's adab, there's ilm. Ya Allah, to you I complain not about what's happening and your decree. I complain about ba'fa quwwati, the weakness in my strength. وَقِلَّةَ حِيلَتِي, and that to you I complain about me running out of options. وَهَوَانِي عَلَى النَّاسِ, and ya Allah, to you I complain about how people are treating me. أَنْتَ رَبُّ الْمُسْتَضَعْفِينَ وَأَنْتَ رَبِّي, you are the Lord of the oppressed. The oppressed are not alone. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us, "Anta Rabbul Mustadafin." You are the Lord of the oppressed. You are the support of the oppressed. You are the aid of the oppressed. You are with those who are oppressed. You are with those who are dealt with unjustly. Anta Rabbul Mustadafin. They have no Lord other than you, and you are with them. You give them that strength, and you give them that endurance, and you stand with them. Anta Rabbul Mustadafin. For the oppressed have no refuge to seek but you, Ya Allah. وَأَنْتَ رَبِّي, and you are my Lord. You are my support. As if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us, I have no more support from the humans. There is no one. And there are few, obviously, you know, Sahaba were in Makkah radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. Lakin, النبي sallallahu alaihi wasallam seeks strength from Allah. And then the end of the dua, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِلَّمْ يَكُنْ بِكَ غَضَبٌ عَلَيَّ فَلَا أُبَالِي. Ya Allah, so long you are not displeased with me and my performance, then I do not care about anything. I think that dua, the prophetic dua for Ta'if, is something we should really look at and reflect upon, because it's something that's repetitive when you are dealt with unjustly or oppressed. So this is the one incident or few incidents that happened, the embargo, the passing away of Abu Talib, passing away of Khadija, going to Al-Ta'if and being dealt with this way, as maybe as a compensation. Allah takes the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after that on the miraculous journey of Isra and Mi'raj. And I've always thought, what was the wisdom? Obviously, there's many lessons to be learned, that first of all, ba'da kulli mihnatin minha, after every difficulty, there is a gift, not just ease. Al-Quran assures you there's ease. Inna ma'al usri yusra. Inna ma'al usri yusra. Tankir al-yusr wa ta'rif al-usr. Right? No, but more than that, as if the Quran and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is showing us that every difficulty you endure and persist in, they will not just be ease, they'll be a gift. Because you've passed the test. You stood your principles. You did not sell yourself to the devil. You did not sell yourself cheap. You did not exchange your noble principles with some other principles. Things were not up for transactional sale. And therefore there's a gift for that, and there's a reward. As if after every mihna, there is minha, number one. Number two, maybe. as if the message is, Ya Rasulallah, if the people on earth don't appreciate you enough, let us show you the miraculous creation of heavens. They will appreciate you. Another lesson, and I don't want to take too long here. We have 5 minutes. Preparing the Sahaba. What do you mean preparing the Sahaba? Preparing the Sahaba for more sacrifice. What do you mean the journey of Isra and Mi'raj? Preparing the Sahaba for more sacrifice. The Isra and Mi'raj happened towards the end of the Meccan phase. It's been 13 years since those group of Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with all of them, have been sacrificing their self, their time, their blood, their wealth, their children. They were killed, persecuted, banished, had to go to Africa, had to go here. I mean, what do you mean? There's more? Yeah. As if the Isra and Mi'raj was preparing the Sahaba to abandon their home entirely and migrate out of Mecca. As if what happened in 13 years is not enough. There's no place for you here for this moment. You need to leave. And you leave with the shirts on your back, like we say. You leave with nothing. So the wealthy Sahaba, the people who had businesses and all that, left everything in Mecca and went to Medina absolutely poor. And that the Isra and Mi'raj gave them that strength. Why did it give them that strength? Because number one, they really believed Rasulullah and believed in him. They believed him and believed in him. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa sallam. What do you mean they believed him and believed in him? Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj is a journey from ilmu al-yaqeen to aynu al-yaqeen to haqqu al-yaqeen. Yani, yaqeen means certainty or certitude. So it's one thing, on an example, it's one thing that you believe in Jannah, and all of you believe in Jannah. May Allah give you all Jannah. Amen. That's an easy dua. May Allah give everybody Jannah. May Allah guide everybody and give everybody Jannah. Jannah is big. We don't have to. Some people, they want to withhold. Huh? Withhold for what? We would love guidance for everyone. May Allah guide everyone, every human being, and may Allah put every human being in Jannah. What's that? There is al-hadith fi sahih al-hadith, where a Bedouin comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and I'm saying a Bedouin in the old days, this mentality still exists. It's called shuh. The low levels of selfishness. I'm not talking about the man here, but I'm talking about us. This Bedouin, who's a Sahabi, he was taken by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's awe and presence. So in the salah, he said loudly, Allahumma arhamni warham Muhammadan wa la tarham ahadan ba'dana. Ya Allah, grant me mercy first, and then after me grant Muhammad mercy. And after both of us, do not give your mercy to anybody. Khalas. Everybody can go to Jahannam. But only me, first him. Notice. Now he is behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his imam. But he puts himself first. Allahumma arhamni, Ya Allah, give me mercy, first me. And then after me, give Muhammad also mercy. After us, do not give your mercy to anybody. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called him. He says, لَقَدْ حَجَّرْتَ وَاسِعًا. You are restricting something that should not be restricted. Ya Habibi, share. Share. Allah وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا سَمَاوَاتْ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah's kingdom is vast. He gives you. Those who withhold only withhold from themselves. And those who display generosity selflessly will never outdo their Lord in reciprocation. Allah is Kareem. One lesson is preparing for more sacrifice. And as-sahaba were being prepared by the Isra and Mi'raj. I said, it's one thing to see, to believe in Jannah, you believe in Jannah. It's one thing for you, that's ilmul yaqeen. It's another thing to witness Jannah. That's aynul yaqeen. Imagine now, you witness Jannah, you look Jannah is in front of you. It's another to enter Jannah and experience Jannah. That's haqqul yaqeen. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that journey took us with him from ilmul yaqeen, from believing in Jannah, to a haqq, to aynul yaqeen, to witnessing Jannah, and then also to haqqul yaqeen, to actually experiencing Jannah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therefore, that gave the Sahaba strength. Because now, it's not something that you just witness, you've experienced it. And that's why you see eventually, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, between my home and my minbar, rawdatun min riyadil jannah. Yani the closeness to Sayyidina wa Mawlana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Jannah by itself. The second thing I'll mention here is the importance of the masajid. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام from المسجد الحرام where to المسجد الأقصى. Look at the significance of the مسجد الحرام and its connection to المسجد الأقصى. And that's why Muslims can never forget المسجد الأقصى. People can go, people can come, politics change, politics doesn't change. Until Qiyamah, the Ummah will always remember Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. It's not erasable because Al-Quran is not erasable. And therefore in these times of difficulties that are happening to the people around Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, where you have indiscriminate killing of children, and you have unprecedented levels of violence that's portrayed under the watch of all free societies and democratic systems. And the media that chooses to selectively show or narrate the news and not. We have a responsibility to the truth and to the human beings, our fellow human beings, who may not know the suffering of the people there, of the children, of the innocent elderly and the innocent women that are being indiscriminately bombarded every day mercilessly. Because Islam teaches us a very simple basic rule. If you fail to identify with the suffering of your fellow creation, not just your fellow human being, if you fail to identify with the suffering of your fellow human beings, then you haven't only betrayed your faith, Islam, but you've also failed the test of your existence in your time. Islam teaches us that we need to care about a cat that's being abused, a dog that's thirsty, as in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Not a human being that's suffering. Al-Masjid al-Aqsa is mentioned there for a reason. But the journey does not end there. Masjid al-Haram, Al-Masjid al-Aqsa, and then another masjid sort of, Al-Baytul Ma'mur. So the whole journey of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is between masajid, and that shows you the importance of masajid. Do not ever abandon the masajid, no matter what it is. The masjid is not the house of anybody. The masjid is the house of Allahu Rabbul Alameen. And you are all and we are all the slaves of Allah. Wa anna al-masajida lillah. And the masajid are for Allahu Rabbul Alameen. And your journey in life, the ayah is giving us an understanding that your journey in life should be a journey between masajid. مسجد الحرام, مسجد الأقصى, البيت المعمور. That's how your journey in life. And what a journey if you spend your life between the masajid. So that whenever, if you go astray, you come to the next masjid. If you go astray, you go to the next masjid, and you're continuously being then corrected. Last thing I need to finish, because I took 5 minutes from Maulana. He told me one, but he said, Sheikh, take 5 more minutes. But I thought I wasn't going to do that, but I did. Let me just say this. The other thing that's important is, or a notion. You know how the prophets, alayhim as-salam, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Isra and Mi'raj ascended to heavens? The first heaven was who? Who was there? Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, right? What, how did Sayyiduna Adam receive Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, marhaban bil-ibni salih wal-nabiyy salih. Welcome my righteous son, Ibn Salih. Right, welcome my righteous son and the righteous prophet. What makes a father happy after they pass? Righteous son. Righteous son. Not how much, welcome the rich son, welcome the poor son, welcome this son, welcome the righteous son. Adam is saying that as a message also for all of us. The sons that you have, or the children that you have, are those that are righteous. Work on that. Don't outsource that to the internet. وصلى الله على محمد وآله والحمد لله رب العالمين.
تكبير الله أكبر ولله الحمد. شكرا جزاك الله خير. إن فضيلة الشيخ بايباي ترمكاسي. الشيخ is well versed with Malaysian, so I can use ترمكاسي. سما. Sheikh, Jazakallah for a beautiful, very soul-stirring nasiha. We really appreciate it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq and hidayah to understand and to implement. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. And for highlighting the lessons of Mi'raj and Isra, which is so current, the suffering that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba went through, and what our Palestinian brothers and sisters and children are going through boycotting and severe oppression. May Allah grant victory to the people in Gaza, in Palestine, and all over the world. Amin ya Rabbal Alameen. On behalf of Masjid al-Quds, we want to say big shukran to Medina Institute, Sidi Hafiz Mahmoud Khatib, Hafiz Sheikh Faisal Royka, and all the team of Medina Institute for affording us this opportunity to have Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya al-Nanawi here today. And we also welcome one of our senior ulama in the Western Cape, Sheikh Muhammad Kalu, who is also part of the entourage. Jazakallah khair. Sheikh, when we finish, bring the chair to the front. You need to sit with the great ulama. Barakallahu fiqh. We have been asked to make dua shifa for Ashik Ratanji. Allah grant him shifa and kamila. And also for Mr. Fairoz Osman, the son of Mr. Mahmoud Osman Murtaza. May Allah grant him and all our people at home and in hospital who are sick and ill. Allah grant him all shifa and kamila. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. I would like to encourage each and everyone to kindly visit our gift shop at the back. We are having a complete clearance sale, 50% off all, and all the proceeds are only for the maintenance of the masjid. So I'm not promoting business here, I'm promoting support for Masjid al-Quds. And then of course at Dalla Umar Center, opposite the road in Hazel Road, they invite all freedom-loving people to come and join them for the announcement of the International Court of Justice at 2 p.m. with regard to the outcome how South Africa took Israel, the illegitimate state of Israel, to the International Court of Justice. May we have a successful and victorious outcome. Amin ya Rabbal Alameen. And then of course we sadly announced the janaza of Haji Noor Muhammad Bawa. Of course everyone know Mebu Bawa, and that is his father, Haji Noor Muhammad Bawa, who passed on in Doha, and his janaza will take place in Doha. We pray to Almighty Allah to grant sabr and contentment in the heart of Haji Maryam Bawa, Mebu Bawa, and all the siblings and family. May Allah grant Haji Noor Muhammad Bawa Jannatul Firdaus and open the windows of heaven and receive his soul with maghfirah and divine love. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. And last but not least, I want to say Mubarak to all our matriculants who have done very, very well. Our school opposite the road, Rylands High, we really salute you for the wonderful work that you are doing on very high level of achievement of our matriculants. And I especially want to mention the two top students because they both achieved 7 distinctions each. And to achieve 7 distinctions is no joke. It is really putting in everything, everything, and this is the result that you get. And we, alhamdulillah, we salute Abdul Dayan Dalong and Ilham Willie from Rylands High, who both achieved 7 distinctions. May Allah continue to bless Rylands High and all our schools, even our Islamic high schools in Mitchell's Plain, everywhere they did very, very well. And those matriculants who didn't do it, don't be frustrated, don't give up, try again. As we say in Afrikaans, aanhouer wen. Persist with your hard work, you will, أَلَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. Human beings will only achieve what they strive for. And this is definitely last not but least, Umrah Maqbula to all our people who are back from Umrah, Mawlana Rafiq Gaby, and all the tens of people who have returned from Umrah. Alhamdulillah, may Allah grant you Umrah Maqbula, Dhanban Maghfura, Wa Amalan Mutaqabbala, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all your du'as, because we know that we have all been included in your du'as. Shukran, Jazakallah Khair, and Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya al-Nanawi, once again, Jazakallah Khair, Shukran for gracing us today. We are indeed honored to have our honorable, beloved Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya al-Nanawi. And for the remainder while you are here in Cape Town, may Allah bless Cape Town. May Allah bless South Africa with your presence. And may as Hafiz Mahmoud Khatib and Madina Institute give Sheikh the best treatment. And I also wish to say earlier, I told Sheikh, he looks very tired and fatigued. Please take Sheikh to Cape Point, not only lectures, take Sheikh around and make sure that Sheikh have kusistas Sunday morning, inshallah. The actual. Shukran, terima kasih, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله لا إله إلا الله
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين، ربي اختم لنا بخير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونشكره، نستعينه سبحانه وتعالى، نستهديه ونستغفره، نعوذ به جل وعلا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده، ونصر عبده، وأعز جنده، وهزم الأحزاب وحده، لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده، أول بلا ابتداء، دائم بلا انتهاء، لا يفنى ولا يبيد، ولا يكون إلا ما يريد، لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام، ولا يشبه الأنام، حي لا يموت، قيوم لا ينام. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمدًا صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم عبد الله ورسوله ونبيه وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. وأشهد أنك يا سيدي يا رسول الله قد أديت الأمانة، وبلغت الرسالة، ونصحت الأمة، وكشفت بإذن ربك الغمة، وعبدت الله ربك حتى أتاك اليقين. صل اللهم عليه وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين، وارض اللهم عن أزواجه وذرياته وأصحابه وأحبابه والتابعين، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله، أحثكم وإياها على طاعته، أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته، وأستفتح بالذي هو خير. أما بعد، يقول مولانا عز وجل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ألم نشرح لك صدرك، ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك، ورفعنا لك ذكرك، فإن مع العسر يسرا، إن مع العسر يسرا، فإذا فرغت فانصب، وإلى ربك فارغب. وقال سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم: عجبا لأمر المؤمن، إن أمره كله خير. أقول قولي هذا، وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم، فاستغفروه يغفر لكم.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد واتم ونم وتفدل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين وأشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وسلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل صحابة أجمعين.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ما اتصلت عين بنظر وسمعت أذن بخبر، وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم خاتم الأنبياء النبي الإمام المعتبر. صل اللهم عليه وعلى آله أهل الفقه والنظر والعلم والأثر، وعلى من بآثارهم اقتفى واهتدى واعتبر. عباد الله، اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه، راقبوه مراقبة من يعلم ويعتقد بأنه يراه. تزودوا من دنياكم لآخرتكم عملا يحبه ويرضاه. اعلموا أنه لا يضر وينفع، ويعطي ويمنع، ويصل ويقطع، ويخفض ويرفع إلا الله. واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه، قال تعالى: ولم يزل قائلا عليما: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، أعلي يا مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه، من أراد بهم غير ذلك فاهده يا ربنا سواء السبيل. آت أنفسنا تقواها، زكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اشف اللهم مرضانا، عاف مبتلانا، فك أسرانا، ارحم موتانا، اغفر اللهم لنا ولوالدينا ومشايخنا ومن له حق علينا ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وآله. أقيم الصلاة.
Inshallah, in the second rak'at, Sheikh will bring the kunut al-nazila. Allah grant victory to the mujahideen. Amen.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة خير الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله،
حقا لا إله إلا الله، سيدنا محمد رسول الله. استووا واستقيموا، straighten your lines. الله أكبر. انجد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم
غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم. ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون. فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون. إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهونهم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده سبحان. سمع الله لمن حمده. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعلي بفضلك وكرمك يا رب العالمين كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم انصر المستضعفين في فلسطين وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المظلومين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن للمظلومين سندا وعونا يا الله، للمستضعفين سندا وعونا يا الله، يا أرحم الراحمين، يا أكرم الأكرمين، يا رب العالمين. يا الله إنا نسألك ونتوجه إليك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العليا أن تحقن دماء المسلمين، أن ترحم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، أن يا ربي تستر على أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، أن تتلطف بأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. اللهم إنهم أصبحوا بلا مأوى ولا نصير ولا طعام ولا شراب ولا ماء. اللهم كن لهم عونا ونصيرا يا رب العالمين، يا أكرم الأكرمين. إن نسألك ونتوجه إليك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العليا أن ترحم الشهداء يا رب العالمين، يا ربي أن تشفي المجروحين والمكلومين يا رب العالمين، الأطفال الأيتام يا رب العالمين، أن تكن لهم يا ربي يا كريم. يا الله يا أرحم الراحمين نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وآله وأصحابه وسلم، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله العظيم والتواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم، ونتوب إليك ونسألك توبة ومغفرة وهداية لنا، فإنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام وإليك يعود السلام، فحينا ربنا بالسلام وادخلنا الجنة برحمة دارك دار السلام. تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. تقبل الله منا منكم. جمعة مباركة.